Today we're talking about Patricia DeLille, because this channel doesn't just make fun of the African National Congress, despite how easy they make it. So yes, today we're talking about Patricia DeLille, mayor of Cape Town and prominent member of the Democratic Alliance. So what is going on with her? Well, she's locked into an ongoing legal battle with her own party, which is, well, not a great place to be as a person who wants to be elected again. The conflict is so weird that, in February, she survived a motion of no confidence by a whisker after she was backed by the ANC, EFF, and a number of DA councillors. Yeah, it's never a good sign for anyone when your own party is trying to remove you from office, but opposition parties are voting to keep you in. Because I get the feeling that the parties she consistently denounces aren't fighting to keep her in office because they see potential in her ability to grow as a leader. So what is going on with all of this craziness? Well, it all started in January when
the Democratic Alliance has resolved to charge its mayor of Cape Town, Patricia DeLille, with misconduct and for bringing the party into disrepute.
Alright, so misconduct is pretty broad and sounds more like getting drunk at a party or using the wrong fork to eat a salad. Oh, Harold, did you see the misconduct of Stephen's girlfriend last night? She rested her elbows on the table. There were 8 serious allegations against her that I will briefly go over though. First, we have the charge of undue influence. Yes, undue influence. Certainly an odd allegation to throw at someone who seems to not even be able to maintain influence in their own party. The charge here is that she acted improperly in reappointing city manager Ahmed Ibrahim by sending members of the appointing committee a text saying, "I want to keep Ahmed, so score him the highest. Thanks." Yeah, I'm sorry, but that is definitely improper. You can't end that message with a thanks. This is definitely a full-on thank you situation. You're not asking them to pick up milk at the store. You're asking them to sacrifice some of their integrity by highly ranking people you like instead of people they think would be right for the job. The second point is improper appointment. Now this is a different appointment, the appointment of Limia Esop to the Stadium Management Board. And it does not bode well for your case when you have to clarify which corrupt appointment you're talking about. So in this case, Mayor DeLille added Limia Esop, the daughter of her close friend, to the shortlist of people being considered for the Stadium Management Board job, because of her legal experience. Now, unfortunately, since January, Mayor DeLille has had more legal experience than her by virtue of her many appearances in the defendant's chair. Because, at the time, Limia was still working on her basic legal qualifications. Next, we see the charge of failing to exercise her duties as mayor. And what do you know, this is another appointee scandal. Wow, they really pulled out a legal thesaurus to find different ways of accusing someone for similar crimes this time. So, this scandal had to do with her overlooking problems in the reappointment process of incumbent commissioner for the Transportation Department, Melissa Whitehead. In this case, Melissa Whitehead had made some suspect payments throughout the years when buying bus chassis from several large companies. A confidential report that was so confidential it immediately popped up upon Google search found that Mayor DeLille refused to let the city manager, also known as the guy who got appointed to his job via the first scandal and text messages we were talking about, report these irregularities to city council. This also covers accusations 4, 5, and 6, not abiding by the Financial Management Act, unreported irregularities, and financial losses matter. Now, the next point, abusive manner, really seems like one they just included to pad the list a bit. You know, maybe they looked at it and thought, you know, 7 doesn't really have the same impact as 8, let's add the extra crime of being mean to caucus members who didn't agree with her. Lastly, we find, refused to accept official decision, because when J.P. Smith was elected as deputy leader of the caucus and council, DeLille refused to work with him, which escalated pretty quickly to the point where
DeLille And Mayoral Committee Member for Safety and Security JP Smith has come to a head. They have now both been placed on special leave following a public spat.
Yeah, they maintain their positions, but neither of them were allowed to go back to the DA's party until people found out what the heck was going on. So, what happened? Well, Mayor DeLille shut down the Special Investigations Unit, which triggered J.P. Smith to go on an accusatorial storm that would have made Donald Trump blush, accusing her of going over his head to shut down the unit because some of them might have known about irregular expenditures to install a new security system in her house using city council money? Although he did clarify that he had never heard those allegations, but that such comments, made or gossip, may perhaps have made DeLille suspicious or mistrusting of the Special Investigations Unit. So, what? You had never heard the allegations you were alleging. There's a rumor going around that I haven't heard yet that DeLille is doing something wrong. She, on the other hand, alleges that she shut down the unit because it was overstepping its jurisdiction, both by investigating crimes outside of Cape Town and by looking into crimes that were not special investigations and should have been performed by your standard police officers. Alright, so those are the accusations. Now, how is it all developing? People are referring to it in terms of boxing rounds, which was perpetuated by her posing with boxing gloves. So,
round one, fight!
Alright, so this first round was Democratic Alliance Caucus led by J.P. Smith taking on Mayor DeLille, and they got in a few early jabs by filling out an internal vote of no confidence. It's clear that they were going for a quick KO, but despite the fact that they landed a few punches and successfully voted no confidence, Mayor DeLille hung in there, despite the fact that that meant that they were going to petition the DA's federal executive to remove her from her position as mayor and leader of the caucus. Which brings us to
round two. Fight!
Alright, so DeLille was ready this round. She probably met with her coach, aka legal team, and came out swinging. Her targets, the higher-ups in the Democratic Alliance. She wrote her letter directly to the Democratic Alliance federal executive, saying an adverse decision will be challenged in court. Any attempt to communicate the decision in a manner or at a time which will make it more difficult for me to obtain urgent relief will be pertinently pointed out to the dirty judge. This will, for instance, be the case of a decision that is communicated late on a Friday or over the course of a weekend. And, just like that, the fight was back. She was particularly cautious because the Democratic Alliance Caucus was doing one of those wind-ups by trying to pass a new recall clause that would make it easier to remove her. I feel like I need to drop this whole boxing motif, because it's really showing how little I understand about the sport. Although, I do need to use it one more time to transition to
round three.
On April 17th, a clause was passed in the DA Constitution that would allow them to recall politicians, called the DeLille Clause. Real subtle, guys. Well, on April 26th, the Cape Town Democratic Alliance again successfully voted no confidence to start the process of removing her through the DeLille Clause.
Of course, the story that broke overnight, Cape Town Mayor Patricia DeLille has lost a motion of no confidence by the DA caucus in the council.
Oh yeah, and on top of all that, there's this weird new charge being discussed, where basically, during a recent radio interview, she was asked if, the morning after she won the court case, would she resign from the DA, to which she responded, "I will walk away." He summed it up correctly. Because really, it is not about hanging on. I'm serving there at the behest of the DA. To which, I presume, an overly ambitious intern snapped his fingers, ran to his boss, and said, "The DA Constitution states a member ceases to be a member of the party when he or she publicly declares his or her intention to resign, and publicly declares his or her resignation from the party." And to my surprise, the party listened and added that interview to the arguments for why she should leave. Which, wow, I've not seen a party so eager to dump one of their successful candidates. She did clarify that she was talking about retiring from mayor and not the party, To which the DA responded with a resounding,
"La la 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 la, I am not listening, la 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 la."
No offense, but people are really starting to report how desperate this is all getting. I haven't seen a party this desperate to get rid of a leader. Although, I'm from a country where Donald Trump somehow still maintains above an 85% approval rating amongst his Republican Party. So, a lack of party loyalty in general just blows my mind. This most recent report from early May shows two updates. First, Patricia DeLille is taking DA members to court for defamation, specifically saying that rival J.P. Smith launched a smear campaign against her. Although, when you're a party, you're not going to be singing someone's praise when you're trying to get them out of there. A specific allegation was that the party gave away positions to counselors who voted against her, which, if true, way to stick to your guns on that one. We need to get her out of office because she was corrupting employment selection in the Cape Town government. What? You don't agree? Well, here's a better job if you change your mind. This method of taking the Democratic Alliance to public court led the Democratic Alliance to release a statement saying, "During the course of these deliberations, we received legal papers from Ms. DeLille advising that she intends approaching the courts. As a result, we have suspended discussions pending legal advice." Oh man, that makes this whole thing seem about as legitimate as that 99-cent DVD I just bought with the Chinese subtitles I can't remove. So, now that she's bringing a public case against them, they're backing off and seeking legal advice to see what to do next. I'll continue following this, but as of now, that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this last video, and if you want to support independent journalism researching South Africa, slam that subscribe button and drop us a like. And, as always, thank you for watching.